Now, one dimensional elastic collision. Consider two smooth spheres A and B. These two are moving with velocities u1 and u2 along a line joining their centers in the same direction. Their masses are m1 and m2. These two are non-rotating spheres. u1 is greater than u2. So, the sphere A approaches the sphere B and collides. After collision, let their velocities be v1 and v2. They are moving along the same direction. The collision is perfectly elastic collision. It means momentum is conserved and kinetic energy is also conserved. Since momentum is conserved, total momentum before collision is equal to total momentum after collision. What is total momentum before collision? M1 U1 plus M2 U2 is equal to M1 V1 plus M2 V2. Equation number 1. Now, M1 into U1 minus V1 is equal to M2 into V2 minus U2, equation number 2. Here, kinetic energy is also conserved because it is elastic collision. Since KE is conserved, total kinetic energy before collision is equal to total kinetic energy after collision. Half M1 U1 square plus half M2 U2 square is equal to half M1 V1 square plus half M2 V2 square. That implies half gets cancelled. M1 into U1 square minus V1 square is equal to M2 into V2 square minus U2 square. This is equation number 3. Dividing the equation 3 with the equation 2, we get 3 by 2 implies M1 into U1 square minus V1 square. M1 into U1 square minus V1 square by M1 into U1 minus V1 is equal to M2 into V2 square minus U2 square by M2 into V2 minus U2. That implies here M1 gets cancelled. U1 square minus V1 square can be written as U1 plus V1 into U1 minus V1. U1 plus V1 into U1 minus V1 by U1 minus V1 is equal. Here M2 gets cancelled. This can be written as V2 plus U2 into V2 minus U2 by V2 minus U2. Okay, V2 minus U2 gets cancelled, U1 minus V1 gets cancelled. Then U1 plus V1 is equal V2 plus U2. That implies U1 minus U2 is equal V2 minus V1. This is an important relation. equation number 4. Okay. From this, what is u1 minus u2 and what is v2 minus v1? Here, try to understand. Before collision, these two spheres approach each other. Then only collision takes place. After collision, they separate from each other. So, before collision, they approach and after collision, they separate. Right? Here, u1 minus u2 is called relative velocity of approach before collision. Relative velocity of approach before collision. What is this? Relative velocity of separation after collision. So, in an elastic collision, the relative velocity of approach before collision is equal relative velocity of separation after collision. This is an important relation. From this, what is V2? V2 is equal to U1 minus U2 plus V1. Am I right? V2 is equal to U1 minus U2 plus V1. Substitute this value in equation number 1. Then, we can eliminate V2 and we can find V1. Are you understanding? From this equation, first find V2. What is V2? U1 minus U2 plus V1. Substitute this value in equation number 1. Then what happens? V2 will be eliminated. You can calculate V1 value. Right? Here I calculate. 1 implies M1 U1 plus M2 U2 is equal to M1 V1 plus M2 V2. Okay. Now, M1 U1 plus M2 U2 is equal to M1 V1 plus M2. I don't write V2. Instead of V2, I write U1 minus U2 plus V1. U1 minus U2 plus V1. Okay. Plus V1. U1 minus U2 plus V1. Right. Next, on simplifying, M1 U1 plus M2 U2 is equal to M1 V1 plus M2 U1 minus M2 U2 plus M2 V1. Now, here is U1, here is U1. So, take U1 as common. M1 minus M2 into U1 plus here is U2, here is also U2. Bring this U2 to this side. 2M2 U2 is equal. Here is V1, here is also V1. Take V1 as common, M1 plus M2 into V1, right? Now, V1 is equal, send M1 plus M2 to other side. M1 minus M2 by M1 plus M2 into U1 plus 2M2 U2 by M1 plus M2. Okay, we have determine the value of V1. What is V1? Velocity of the first sphere after collision. Then we determine V2. How can we find V2 from this equation? First find V1 and substitute it in the equation number 1. V1 will be eliminated. You can calculate V2. Okay. Now 4 implies 4 implies, here we determined V2. Now, I find V1. V1 is equal V2 minus U1 plus u2. Okay, if I substitute v1 in equation number 1, v1 will be eliminated and you can calculate v2 value. That is simple thing. Substituting in equation number 1, we have, here I substitute, this is equation number 1, I continue from this, okay, m1 u1, no change, m2 u2, here also no change, I don't write v1, instead of v1, I write v2 minus u1 plus u2 plus m2 v2, there is no change. Okay. Now simplify it. Simplify it. M1 u1 plus m2 u2 is equal to m1 v2 minus m1 u1 plus m1 u2 plus m2 v2. Okay. Now, here is u1. Here is also u1. Bring that minus m1 u1 to LHS side. It will be 2m1 u1. Okay. Here is u2. Here is also u2. Bring that u2 to LHS side. Plus m2 minus m1 into u2 is equal, here is v2, here is also v2, take v2 as common, m1 plus m2 into v2, so finally v2 is equal 2m1 u1 by m1 plus m2 plus m2 minus m1 by m1 plus m2 into u2. Thus, we determined v2 value. What is v2? Velocity of the second sphere after collision. In this way, we determined the velocities of the two spheres after collision. Here are some special cases.